श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देव महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात् परम ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः अवर परसेप्शंस depend upon the standpoint or the angle from what we are looking at an object. If we are looking at an object from a lower angle, the object appears to be tall. If we are looking at the same object from the top, it starts looking very shallow or short. The right angle, you get the right perception. See, like the picture which is behind, you may be seeing the picture very good because you are at a proper distance. Suppose you go nearer to that picture, maybe 2 inches or 1 inch, and try to see the picture. You will see, but it will be incomplete perception. If you go far away, maybe about 5 miles away, you won't see it. In the same manner, when we go through the experiences of our life, we have to recognize what standpoint we are taking to analyze the experiences of our life. So there are different standpoints. First standpoint is as per this Upanishad, then we start living as body, by heart. Second standpoint is we start living as Antaratma, the Jiva. The third standpoint is we start living as Paramatma. Now when these three standpoints are clear in our understanding, then only our spiritual practice will have a direction and meaning. So first standpoint, we start living as body, rather we are been living only as body. Now what we have got in our life, by living as a body, we all have the data available. This experiment we have done. So what did we get? We got friends, we got enemies, we got relations, we got possessions, we have got success, we have got failure, etc., etc. Has this given us freedom and joy? If yes, continue. If no, then we take the second chance. Second standpoint is, we are no more the body but the embodied. So who is that embodied? So an unknown is indicated by X. See, if you take an example, some data is given to us and then we are asked, therefore what is the average weight of mango? So you have given earlier a lot of data, on the basis of that you have to deduct. What is the average weight of mango? So how do we start? Suppose the average weight of mango is X kilogram. And in that X kilogram, you submit your answer book. Do you get the marks? We have to establish the value of X. In the same manner, after we have done this experiment in our life, that I am the gross body, and if we are not satisfied with this thing, then we take the next step. That I cannot be the body, I have to be embodied. So this embodied is called as X. This X is called as soul. The soul is called as Jiva. And here we make the mistake. We accept that X as an answer. We have to establish the value of X. Who is this Jiva? What is this Jiva? See friends. This is not accepted, and blindly the Jiva is taken as an individuality. This is in the Karma Kanda, this is in the, you know, Yoga Shastra, this is in the Sankhya Shastra, and therefore they come to the second standpoint, that per body there is one embodied. So as many bodies, so many jivas, so many souls. And then the questions are asked. When so many people are born, and so many die, where do the jiva go? How can they accommodate where they are living? So we are taking the jiva as some kind of entity. See, friends, imagine all the bulbs in this room suddenly become fused. Then the question will be, where all the lights have gone? There the jivas go after death. Therefore, when we take the second standpoint, that the embodied I am, then without inquiry, like in yoga, etc., without inquiry, when we take the soul or the jiva as the individual reality, then our quality of life and the spiritual practice will be different. What will be your quality of life? We will be caught up in cause and effect. We will be all the time talking about last life, this life, next life. We will be all the time living our life under the burden of the sin and the merit, going to hell and heaven. And there is no end to. And if we take the third standpoint, what is the meaning of this jiva, the soul? Who is this soul? From here we enter the Upanishad. See, friends, both the things, nasato vidyate bhavaha na bhavo vidyate sadaha. Paramatma being eternal cannot be born. Jiva being an illusion cannot be born. So who is born? Can we say that the light is born and when we switch off the light is dead? Light is not an entity. Think. When a pot is made, the pot space is born. And when the pot breaks, the pot space dies. See, friends. And therefore, when we are no more satisfied by this KG1, KG2 spirituality, you should do good, you will go to heaven, after you go to heaven, what will happen? You don't have to pay bills. See, friends, it cannot attract a deep inquiring mind. And then such a person takes up the inquiry, who is this embodied? Then you will come to know all the verses or the mantras of the scriptures. They are equally applicable to the absolute real and absolute unreal. Take for example, when Bhagavad Gita Prathopanishad says, Na jayate mriyate vami paschit nayam bhutva bhavitavana bhujaha ajo nityaha shashvatoyam puranaha na hanyate hanyamane sharire. This reality is never born, never dies, it is eternal. And when the body dies, this doesn't die. This is the statement. Now this is equally applicable to Paramatma as well as Jivatma. There is no difference. Na jayate. Jivatma is not born. Can we say when we stand in front of the mirror that the reflection is born? And when we go away from the mirror, do we say that the reflection is dead? So what is the reflection? What is the jiva? It is an appearance. Appearance is na jayate na mriyate. And therefore, ajaha, unborn, eternal. See, friends, when thus we start inquiring, who is this jiva? And then we come to discover jiva is nothing but an expression of the absolute through the limitations of the conditioning of the panchakoshas. It is changing this standpoint. It is for this purpose that the Atma Upanishad is addressing the seekers. See, friends. Otherwise, normal spirituality is the same thing. I want to do this, I want to do that. How long are we going to do and what? Therefore, the real spiritual practice is not doing something, but undoing all that we have been doing in our life. And therefore, we have come to this conclusion in the 15th mantra, that this wise man who is abiding in this Paramatma Tattva, his standpoint is different. And therefore, for him, Priya Priyena Spashataha Tathaiva Chashubhashubhe. For him, there is nothing like liking, disliking, auspicious or not auspicious. However, the ignorant people, like they say the sun is covered by the clouds, in fact, it is the vision of the onlooker which is covered by the clouds and not the sun, in the same manner. Their understanding about the standpoint of the wise man is clouded by ignorance. The wise man is living as absolute consciousness. So, Pashyanti Dehivan Muda Sharira Amasa Darshana. So, when they look upon the Jivan Mukta Purush, they start thinking that the Jivan Mukta Purush and we are the same. What is the difference? But because they are unable to experience this standpoint. See, up to here we have seen. Then the second important thought was taken. And the second important thought was that there is no cause and effect associated with the life of the wise man. So, Devena Niyate Devo, Yatha Kalopa Bhuktishu, Laksha Laksha Gatim Tyaktva, Yattishte Kevalatma. For him, there is no destination to be reached. There is no time required for reaching the destination. There is nothing that is gained and there is nothing that is to be protected. Therefore, Laksha Alaksha Gatim Tyaktva, Yattishte Kevalatma, he who is living as absolute space. See? We can ask the question, where is the earth, where is water, where is fire, and where is air? We cannot ask a question, where is space? Everything is in the space. Everything comes and goes in the space. Space doesn't come and doesn't go anywhere. And this space is in the absolute reality. Kevalatmana. In this manner, such a Jivan Mukta Purush, Shiva eva swayam sakshat, ayam brahma viduttamaha, jivan deva sada muktaha, krutato brahma viduttamaha. Thus, the Jivan Mukta Purush is none other than the Paramatma manifest. Yesterday I told you, manifestation reveals the unmanifest. This is the thumb rule. You see a child. Child is a manifestation. We don't know whose child it is. So we ask him, hey, what is your father's name? Oh, my father's name is Suresh. So, from the effect, we go to the jail. So, the effect is the cause of the cause. Thus, cause and effect, they become illusion. So here, the wise man is no more living as caught up in the cause and effect. So, Shiva eva swayam sakshat brahma viduttamaha. He is now living as absolute reality and manifesting as a jivan mukta. So, jivan neva sada muktaha. He is already liberated while alive. And what is the sign of liberation while alive? Krutartha. Etat buddhva buddhiman syat kruta kruttyascha bharata. There is fulfillment in life. Next time you go or you are by with yourself, give it a try. 10 minutes I have to waste time. Don't use time. Enough of using. Try to waste. You all will agree with me. Suppose you are simplicity. Then you remember, oh, see, instead of simply watching the TV or like that, why not I cut the vegetables or something or the other, we keep on doing. Give it a chance. Just waste time. and then you will come to discover we are most unwanted furniture in this. Those who are workaholics, if you want to punish them, you tell them, don't do anything. So they start moving their leg. You can't do. They can't stop. See? So this habit of doing something or the other, and then our own weakness of workaholism is glorified as sarva bhuta hitirata. I am not doing it for myself, I am doing it for the sake of the society. Society never told any Mahatma to construct a temple. Society never told any Mahatma to have an ashram. Society never told any Mahatma to build schools. Society never told any Mahatma to have orphanages. It is the khujli of the Mahatma that doesn't allow him to keep his mouth shut. See, friends, come to discover this. And therefore, Kritartha, such masters don't do anything. Then things happen around them, like the flower does not give the fragrance. Fragrance happens. The magnet does not invite the iron filings. They come. Bhagavad Gita, 12th chapter, this is my most, you know, favorite shloka from Bhagavad Gita. Yasmanno dvijate lokaha, lokanno dvijate chayaha. He, because of whom others are not disgusted, are a babre aagya. And he who is not disgusted because of the world, both the ways, he is my devotee. See, friends. And therefore, jivan neva sada muktaha, krutartaha, brahma vittamaha. He has attained fulfillment in life. Up to a particular stage in life, yes, we have to do this, we have to do that. If we divide our total life, what should be the scheme of an ideal life? Up to the age of 5 or 6, take care of the children with great love, hugging, kissing, giving love, everything. After they are crossed 6 or 7, up to the age of 13, discipline, value, etc. Independence, doing our job. From 13 to 19, ambition, goal, hard work, achieving success, studies, becoming qualified to face the challenges of life. 13 onward, up to the age of maybe 2 children born and gone to the school or college. After that time, struggle, work hard, love, hate, fall, get up, cheat, loot, everything do. After your children are married or ready to get married, then start slowly withdrawing. And then start looking within. And then we'll come to know our presence is most unwanted in this. And thereafter, life is only fulfilled. Let the life be lived through us. Etat buddhvan buddhiman syat kruta pratyashtana. So, jivan neva sada muktaha. Such a great master, he is already fulfilled in his life. So, upadhina asyat brahmaiva sat brahma peti nirdvayam shainu shovesha sat bhava bhavayashtra yatakumar. Like an actor on the stage. Now, this is one principle in our scriptures which will answer all your questions. Any question regarding anything is answered by this simple technique. And the technique is, life is a mega drama. And in that drama, in every drama, there are two types of two parties. One party is audience, and the second party is the actor. Never become the audience. Become the actor. When you become actor, you get name, you get fame, you get money, you get popularity. And when you become the audience, you pay and start crying. So when you thus become an actor in this mega drama that is going on, then what is the drama? Drama is that where everything appears to be happening, but nothing ever happens. Our life is like a big mega drama. So what an actor is supposed to do, whatever role he has to play, play your role. No, I want to play the role of Rama. I don't want to play the role of Ravana. No, but that is your role. Next time we'll see that. So play your role perfectly well, but don't get entangled imagining that this is the real. And then we'll come to know that in drama, every kind of event is required. Every kind. Good events are required, bad events are required. Imagine. From the Ramayana story, you know, according to Valmiki Ramayana, Bhagavan Ramchandra ruled 11,000 years. According to Valmiki Ramayana. Out of 11,000 years, 14 years he has gone to forest. Out of 14 years, 13 years he was in Chitrakoot, Majja. And remaining 1 year, 6 months he was getting the hospitality of all the saints and sages, and 6 months only Gabbar Singh came. Out of 11,000 years, only this much portion. Even not a fraction. Now remove this portion from edited Ramayana. Let us edit it. What will be the story? Dasharatha did not have, you know, children, so he went to the gynecologist, and then they decided you had to have IVF, and then 4 kids were born, and then Rama was a very good child, and he was taking care of his younger brothers, and then he got married, and then he ruled for 11,000 years. Rama had over. Who will read that now? When in the life of Rama also there are difficulties and problems, then only we get enchanted. Yes, he is a great. See? In the same manner, we all have everything required in our life. With this view, you take a standpoint that life is a big drama. And in that drama, whatever role we have to play, we play the role. Afterwards, Shailu Shavar, remove the clothes and go back, buy half kg of bindi and go. All the actors do this only. Aate mirchi bhi le aana, you always forget. And then they have forgotten that thing. Therefore, all your questions are answered if you take life as a drama. This is how everywhere this example is given. Shailu Shav. That Shailu Shav Veshasat Bhava Bhava Yashtu Yata Bhuman Tathaiva Brahma Visreshta Sadha Brahma Ivana Para. Now see where the Jiva has gone. There is no place for Jiva. See, when I am acting on the stage as Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, that playing the role of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj is the Jiva. Now is that Chhatrapati Shivaji really born? It was only in acting, that's all. In the same manner, we are all expression of the same divinity. The costume is masculine body, beard will grow. Donkey body start reading rather eating newspaper. A cobra body start hissing and producing poison a cow's body start producing milk. Different costumes, different expressions. Because of that, consciousness is neither pious nor unpious, neither poisonous nor nutritious. So where is the jiva? Come to cognize this principle. Let us get out of the jiva. And if we do not get out of the jiva, those people who do meditation, etc., their meditation is all the time what is happening inside. See, when I sat for meditation, you know, some kind of light started moving up. And then suddenly it went. I don't know where it has gone. No, it was pure yoga. One thumb rule keep in your mind. Anything that begins and ends falls in the purview of mind. So simple. It doesn't mean these experiences don't happen. They happen. But don't give value and importance to them. See, many experiences come and go. They all fall in the purview of the illusions, Maya. Patanjali Maharshi very clearly tells, when a person has attained sayama, trayam ekatra sayamaha, when dharana, dhyana, samadhi is perfected, and such a sayamit mind, when that sayamit mind is focused on, like you know, on the esophagus. If we have complete control over the mind, deshaka, deshataha, kalataha, vastataha, dharana, dhyana, samadhi, and when that controlled mind is fully brought in the esophagus, kantapumbis esophagus, when it is brought over here and you hold it on here for a long period of time, you will conquer hunger and thirst. It happens. But then this siddhis, they start attracting us so much that we forget our destination, living as absolute conscious blissful existence. And therefore, let us not give any value, any importance to these. So, tathaiva brahma visreta, sada brahma iva na aparaha. Aparaha means jiva. He is not a jiva. So, what is the jiva stage now? Antaratma. Jiva is in-between step from the manifest to the unmanifest, and in-between subtle manifest. So the gross world, Dehatma Bhav, Bahyatma. The subtle world, Jivatma Bhav, Antaratma. And absolute reality, Paramatma, who is expressing through the conditioning of the panchakoshas and behaving as if he or she is an individual. Get this picture clear in your mind and see the joy. For such a person, there is no celebration. Happy birthday to you. And there is no mourning also. No possibility. So, Gatena Steyata Vyomayo Vyoma Bhave Bhavati Swayam. So, when the pot breaks, the pot space doesn't become the total space. Even when the pot was, that time also the pot space was only total space. So, whether the body is there or not, mind is there or not, we were, we are, and we will always continue to be this absolute conscious, blissful existence, whether we accept or we don't accept. We are that. See, friends, there is no place, papu ham, papa karma ham. That is for taking dakshina. So, tatha evo upadhi vilaye brahma eva brahma visvayam kshire. Kshiram kshire rata kshiptam tailam taile jagam jane. In the same manner, upadhi vilaye. When the wise man has discarded his conditioning of bahyatma and antaratma, He is the absolute self, and he has discovered this. And after having discovered, he thereafter starts living from a different standpoint. In case of Yoga Shastra, there is a sutra right in the first chapter. There the yoga is defined as yogaha chitta vritti nirodaha. But this is incomplete definition. The next sutra makes it complete. Tada drashtuhu swarupe avasthana. Only suspension of the thoughts is not yoga. Suspension of the thoughts leading to abidance in the absolute conscious blissful self, that is yoga. But normally what the students of yoga do, they are occupied only with suspension of the thought process. And for that, they are told there are five vrittis, and then to control them, abhyasa vairagya, abhyam tad nirodaha, practice, practice, practice. Practice and repetition is possible only in the finite. Sounds are repeated. Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. I said this mantra 3 times. Silence is not repeated. Sounds are created. Silence is not created. Therefore, we have to discover this truth only once. No abhyasa vairagya abhyam. No abhyasa. Only no once. Therefore, just like the water is poured in the water, you can't differentiate. Milk poured in the milk, you can't differentiate. In the same manner, Brahmaiva Brahma is Svayam. The knowing and being is one. In case of the worldly knowledge, knowing and being is different. I know this is a donkey. And I also know that I am not a donkey. Because the knowing and being is separate. But knowing the Brahman is only by being the Brahman. You cannot know the reality as objective understanding. Therefore, Brahmaya eva Brahmam is Svayam. So their knowing and being is one. That is the experience of the Jivan Mukta. Be attentive. If this is the ultimate truth, that the knowledge is existence, and the existence is that which can never be absent, therefore, can there be absence of knowledge? There cannot be absence of knowledge. Then where from the problem begins? The problem begins when the knowledge is expressing through the limitations of the conditionings. Like, you know, the mind expressing through the limitations of the vision, eyes. Now, they have a limitation of illuminating a particular spectrum of the light waves. Beyond that, our eyes cannot comprehend the light waves. Does it mean that the light waves do not exist beyond that spectrum? No, they exist. So, what is our perception of the light waves? It is not absence, but it is incompleteness. Therefore, ignorance is incomplete knowledge. It is not absence of knowledge. But you see, most of the people, when they define ignorance as jnana, they talk about absence of knowledge. It is wrong. It is not absence of knowledge. Then once we recognize this, that all our perceptions, which are gathered through sense organs and the mind, they fall in the purview of incompleteness in knowledge. And if we want to gain the complete knowledge, what will be the natural spiritual practice? Transcend all that which is gained through the sense organs and the mind and the intellect. Therefore, that experience where no medium of knowledge is involved, that experience is our ultimate recognition of the self. And this we all do every moment. Do we recognize our presence through the sense organs? Do we recognize our presence through the mind? Do we recognize our presence through the intellect as a concept? No. Our presence is independent of all the means of knowledge, pramana nirapeksha anubhuti. See, friends. Therefore, brahmaiva brahmavit svayam, the knower of the Brahman cannot remain apart from the Brahman. Because knowing and being is one. Tatha eva upadhi vinaye, brahmaiva brahmavit svayam, kshiram kshire, tatha akshiptam, tailam taile jalam jale. Then, as a result of this, sayukta mekatam yati tathatmani atmavinmuni evam videha kaivalyam sanmatratvam akhanditam. Now see here, another deep vision is given. In this manner, muni, the contemplative seeker, sayukta ekatam yati atmani atmavinmuni. So he comes to recognize his own being. See, friends. Atmavinmuni. Muni contemplative one. Not a physically oriented. See. This physical orientation keeps us far away from the truth. So, sayukta ekatam yati. He merges in the absolute reality. Evam videha kaivalyam. He attains the kaivalya. Kaivalya is kevalasya bhavaha kaivalyam. Kevalam is what? Where there are no differences accepted as valid. No differences are accepted as valid. Which are the differences? Take an example. South, north, east, west differences. In the space, these differences are not valid. India, Pakistan, Nepal, Bangladesh, these are imaginary lines drawn by the political problematics. There is nothing like that. Today's the map of India is a gift to us by the Britishers. This was never a map any time before. They have come created imaginary line and put the people to fight and went away. Everywhere they have done the same. See, friends, the same river Brahmaputra is called something different in China, then it comes somewhere, it's called something different, then it comes to India, and India also, Brahmaputra is not a feminine river, it is a masculine, Brahmaputra, it is a masculine river. River is the same, we keep on giving the names. Therefore, here there are no differences of any kind. So the differences are, like in example, the space, north, east, west, south, they are not valid for the space. Similarly, the son, husband and the father, these differences are not valid in man. Man exists without remaining as a son, without becoming a husband or without becoming a father. He continues to exist in the same manner. Whether waking experience, dream, deep sleep or samadhi, these experiences are dependent on this absolute undifferentiated reality, that is the kaivalya, where the differences have no value. And therefore, evam videha kaivalyam, here videha means going beyond the bodies. Which are the bodies? First is the gross body, bahyatma. Second is the subtle body, jivatma, the antaratma, and third is the causal body, wrong notion about one's identity. When these three identities or wrong notions are destroyed, then videha kaivalyam happens, and as a result, sanmatratvam akhanditam. Now this is the word which we have to understand very clearly. This I explained a number of times. When I say, before coming to Mumbai, I was in Singapore. Before coming to Singapore, I was in Indonesia. Before going to Indonesia, I was in Ahmedabad. Before going to Ahmedabad, I was in Delhi. So this I is akhanda, unbroken. Delhi is different, Singapore is different, Indonesia is different, Bombay is different, Ahmedabad is different. But I was not different, I am the same. Is it not our experience? Childhood has come and gone, teenage has come and gone, but do we have the experience that we have changed, we are broken in pieces? Now apply the same principle. When we are told that our good and bad karma from the last life are giving us terrible wife in this life, and because we torture her now, next time you will get two wives. Interest. Buy one, get one free. So you will continue to be the same. So when I existed in the last life, when I am existing in this life, and when I exist in the next life, where did I die and where did I born? Therefore, sanmatratvam akhanditam. Come to cognize this akhandatattva. Jagrat avastha comes, Jagrat Purush is born. Jagrat avastha goes along with the Jagrat Purush. Sapna avastha comes, then Sapna Purush is born. He plays his game, that also goes. Sushupti avastha comes, Pragya comes. He also goes. Samadhi comes, remains for some time, goes. But there is one principle which has never come and never gone. This sanmatra, absolute existence. Therefore we have never experienced our absence or our broken presence. Vikar is a broken presence. Vikar is not present in the dream, etc. Dreamer is a broken presence. Beyond the dream, dreamer has no entrance. Thus when we start again and again reflecting that we are essentially sanmatra akhanditam, akhandananda. This is the akhanda. Like, if we have done something good or bad in the dream, is it a punishable act in the waking state? No. In the same manner, he who is living has this akhanda tattva. For him, there is neither gain nor loss, neither achievement nor failure. Therefore, sanmatratvam akhanditam. And if we accept this principle, even in words, may not experience, yet our quality of life will change. See, don't give too much importance to what you have done in the past. Only one thing we can do about the past, one thing, we cannot undo the past. Second thing, we can select, shift, delete the past. Don't carry the load. See? And when we don't understand this principle, we dig our own grave. For example, there was one girl, now she is a mother of two grown up children. Love marriage. And one day, whatever she has to do, she will come and ask me. I said, oh, Swamiji, I am on the crossroads. I said, what book you have purchased? No, not that. I am in a confused state. That, you know, she told some event which happened in her life when she was a child. Maybe class 8, class 9. Some bad event happened. She said, you know, I don't want to hide anything from my husband. He loves me so much. He told me everything of his life. I also want to tell him. So I want your advice. I said, you tell him. And from that day moment onwards, I don't want to talk to you throughout your life. Why? I said, no question of why. Okay, Swami, if you don't like, I will not talk. And she didn't say. Time passed. One child, second child born. And when the marriage crosses something like, you know, 15, 20 years, then all the old wounds starts opening. And Indian husbands are most disgusting creature. And then they will start talking. Tumhare ghar mein yehi sikhaya tha. Your mother has taught you like this. Your father did like this. And if, now that girl came and told me after 15, 20 years of her marriage, she said, Swamiji, I don't know how to thank you. So what happened? Then she said, you know, last 2-3 years, what has gone wrong, God knows. For every small little things, he started digging the past. I have done so much for you. And you do like this thing. This is how your culture is. In our culture, it is not like that. When you got married, that time agriculture. Now it is agriculture. And all kinds of fighting has started, and I am fed up. I said, then why do you thank me? Because you are fed up. She said, no. Now I remember you told me not to tell that event to him. Had I told him that event, he would have blackmailed me throughout my life. See, friends, there is nobody in this world through him, something good or bad has never happened. If somebody says, it is a solid bluff. Knowingly or unknowingly, every one of us have done something or the wrong, sometime or the other, in our so total life. See, friends. And if we carry that load all the time on our head, we are destroying our present. And therefore, here the teacher gives this very simple technique. That do not unnecessarily go on imagining why the Vyasaka, don't worry, remain as a akhanda sanvatra, continuous unbroken presence. And this continuous unbroken presence is able to illuminate everything, but doesn't get influenced by anything. Waking is illumined, dream is illumined, deep sleep is illumined, samadhi is illumined, but doesn't get influenced by anything. See, purnamadaha purnamidam, this is the meaning. Waking and dream does not add to me. Deep sleep and samadhi doesn't take away anything from me. Like waves do not add anything to the ocean, and the waveless ocean is not at a loss. See, sanmatra khanditam. Now find out where the jiva has gone, to hell or heaven. He can go to hell and heaven if he is there. When an actor has committed a murder on the stage, because that was the role he has to play. So he comes, takes the dagger, and the dagger is made up of rubber, and inside there is red ink. And he takes that, you know, and makes that person fall, and so all the blood comes out from the rubber, and again he takes the rubber, again. And then the audience, I don't know, don't do that. And the blood is still here and there, and he goes, when the police come, I am the, you know, witness, I have seen him killing. See, friends, the illuminator is never influenced by what is illumined. I illuminate the waking, I eliminate the dream, deep sleep, samadhi. See, Trishu dhamasu yat bhogyam bhokta bhogascha yat bhave tebhyo vilakshana sakshi chinmatro ham sadashiva. Mai eva sakalam jatam, mai sarvam pratishthitam, mai sarvam layam yati, tad brahmatvayam asmiham. Everything is born in me, everything is bubbling in me, everything goes back in me. See, friends. So many things happen in the space. Space is not in place. So many things are seen by our eyes. Vision is not in place. So many words are heard by our ears. Ears remain the same. So many good and bad thoughts come and go, but the mind remains the same. So many experiences, waking, dream, deep sleep, come and go, the conscious principle ever remains the same. Now what sadhana we are going to do? Remaining in this experience effortlessly, and playing the role of life like an actor who is playing the role of a criminal, yet he is not a criminal, he knows. He is playing the role of a king and he knows that he is not a king. He is playing the role of an artist and he doesn't know how to draw one straight line. And yet he is playing the role in the same manner. The Jivan Mukta Purush, he is playing every role perfectly well, knowing well very much in his heart. He has nothing to do with any role that he is playing. Friends, this knowledge grows very slow but very steadily. It won't show instant effect. Many times we come across people, the other day, one amma here only, she I told her, she lost her mother. She said, Mama, I heard about your mother. She said, Swamiji, I want to thank you. She said, what for? I have taken the whole thing so cool, including myself, everybody was surprised. Because I was extremely attached to my mom. But the whole thing I conducted without losing my cool. And I was surprised, am I that? Because I know how weak I am. Then she said, all that I have been listening to you for last 15, 20 years, that alone has given me this built up stamina to face. Friends, Bhagavad Gita was told to Arjuna. After listening to Bhagavad Gita, the situation of battle did not change. It is Arjuna who changed. Spiritual practice does not mean that the world around us will change. It is we will change. And what is change in us? The change in us is changing the standpoint. Change the standpoint, your perception will change. When your perceptions change, your interaction changes. When interactions change, your experiences change. When experiences change, the quality of life changes. So the real spiritual practice is changing the standpoint. Our present standpoint is I versus you. This is the samsari. Say then, samsari graduates. How he graduates? He gets sufficient kicks. And then he goes to the temple. Oh Lord, with the others, competition. jealousy, frustration, anger, and you know, revenge, hatred. With that kind of mind, now this frustrated fellow goes to the temple. Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Now, with Krishna competition, 16,000 is what? Agni. No competition with Krishna. No jealousy. No frustration. So when a samsari goes to the spiritual path, the first thing as a devotion, the negativities of the mind, competition, jealousy, frustration start disappearing and he starts surrendering. And when he starts surrendering, he has already withdrawn from the relative world, and therefore for the devotee, the law of karma is not applicable. He doesn't bother about papa punya. Yad yad karma karomi tatta dakhilam shambho tavaradana. See friends. And then through the process of devotion, when the mind is entertaining minimum worldly things and beings, in that pure mind, inquiry kindles as to who am I. And then we get the opportunity, Ishvara Anugraha Deva Pumsa Advaita Vasana Mahat Bhaya Paritranan Vipranam Upajayate. Then the God's grace showers on the seeker in the form of longing for the absolute reality. God's grace comes only in this form. And when we thus come to this Atmopanishad, then we come to know that the world, the jiva, the scriptural approach, this is only a process. And all the process is directing towards only one thing. Come to discover in one absolute, infinite multiplicity is only imagined, projected, conditioned, but not real. Thereafter starts living as this absolute conscious, blissful self, and then you are the dispenser of divine bliss in and around you. So Brahma Bhavam Pravadesham Yatirna Vartate Punaha Sadatma Katva Vijnana Dhatta Avidyati Vashmanaha Sache Yati Sache Master. He who has Brahma Bhavam Vartate, now he has already attained oneness with the absolute. You know, this statement is wrong actually. Can we say that the north has become one with the space? Is north like an object? North is just a word. When we say that the wave has become ocean, is wave an object? It is just a name. It's just a form. When we say the ocean is deep, so is the ocean deep? There is nothing but water. So to the same water, we are giving different names, ocean and the waves. In the same manner, this Yati, earlier he was a samsari, then he became a devotee, then his mind became pure, and then he started inquiring, and then he came to discover. The word is discover. He is not attaining something, it is pratasya prapti. It is not we were not earlier Brahman, abhi abhi Brahman ho gaya. See friends, so such a person, sadatmakatva, when he has attained this one absolute being, then vijnana dagdha avidyadi varshmanaha. For him, all the limitations born out of incomplete knowledge. What is incomplete knowledge? Only this body I am. Only this knowledge I am. Only this experience I am. This incompleteness in the knowledge is the effect, and incompleteness in the knowledge is the cause. So when these are totally burned, avidyadi varshmanaha. In Vedanta Shastra, the word used is the chidyate hrudaya granthi vidyante sarva sam vidyate hrudaya granthi chidyante sarva samshayah kshiyante chasya karmani tasmin drushte paravare. He who has thus recognized fully the absolute and also the relative. And what is the recognition? In the absolute, relative is always imagined, projected. It is not real. In this manner, he who has discovered for him first vidyate hrudaya granthi, the knot of the heart, avidya kama karma, incomplete knowledge leading to desire, followed by action, disappears. Vidyate hrudaya granthi, chintyante sarva samshayah, there is no doubt about anything. About what we don't have doubt? Our presence. See? And kshiyante jasya karmani, all the karma, the sanchita karma, prarabdha karma, agami karma, yavridhi disappears. When? Tasmin drishte paravare. Therefore, sadatmakatva vijnana dagdha avidyadi vashmanaha. He who has thus discarded the wrong notions, he who has thus discovered the real self that he is, and such a master, amushya brahma bhutatvat, brahmanaha puta udbhavaha, maya klupto vanda moksho, nastaha svatmani vasthuni. Now such a master, who has now merged himself in the absolute, for him, where is a place for bondage and liberation? Where is the place for birth and death? Because bondage and liberation, they fall in some other purview. What is that? The concluding topic, we shall take it tomorrow in the concluding session. Om Namah Purnamidam.